Thanks. We don't know about what's the word?
What's happening
on the street?
What's happening, Justin?
And don't say Greece. Surfenberg, okay.
I heard it was bird.
The
bird.
I thought just the bird was the word. Yeah.
Oh, hey guys.
Hey.
I have a question.
Hello.
Austin, Texas. The Brew Exchange. How y'all doing?
All right, real quick, just for the record, that's not, I mean, when you ask how you're doing, you say, I'm doing, you know.
I said, how y'all doing?
They said, well.
Because I want to blend in with the locals.
Let's be civilized.
All right.
When you say, how are you doing? I want you to give us a full sentence response, honestly telling us how you're doing.
Yeah.
Just say it as loud as you can. Just say it.
Also, okay. I'm going to say ma'am, and you say sir.
Okay, here we go.
So we have the whole spectrum.
All right, here we go. Austin Brew Exchange, sir?
Ma'am?
How are you doing?
That's right. There we go, yeah.
Five people still did woo.
I hear dentist. Yeah, that's an honest assessment of where they're at. Welcome. This is going to be an epic few hours. I would like to right now introduce, quite possibly, the best band on Earth. Can we please?
I mean, first of all, they're definitely the best band on Earth.
Yeah.
Possibly ever.
Possibly ever.
Some of us read the literature.
We're still researching.
The time thing is, you know, I don't want to say forever.
Yeah.
You never know what bands are going to come later.
Sure.
I mean, in the third epoch of the Glopnorks, there might have been a superior band. I understand.
Exactly.
That's true.
So we're hedging on that.
Yes. But definitely.
But otherwise,
right,
they're
now,
great. Yeah.
They are the greatest band on Earth.
Can we please get a huge response when I introduce the Possum Posse?
An invitation to some sort of shower, and she said, get off your fat one, cause it starts in an hour. And I was just sitting by the TV, and she cut the power. Now how am I gonna find out what happened to Jack Bauer? Well, I ain't going nowhere. Ha! But then she liquored me up, and I was totally down. I said, you can be the queen, honey, just bring me the crown. Yeah, I'm gonna hop on the microphone, maybe try raising a toast. I might holler out loud which gifts I think cost the most. Yeah. Well, now I got burnt out working, so the wife booked a cruise. We're gonna hit the open water, girl. We're gonna shake these blues. But then she invited the in-laws, talking about the cousins and nephews. I don't like my job at all, honey, but if I had to choose, well, I ain't going nowhere. But then she liquored me up. I was totally down. I said, you can be the queen, honey, just bring me the crown, yeah. Cannonball in a pool. Hey, I might holler out iceberg and then just, I'ma play cool. Listen, I've watched Kate and Leopold learn how to Japanese paper fold. I planted a whole bunch of marigolds and I told her I'd have and hold her. Oh, and she liquored me up.
Yes, she did.
Well, she wants to go see Grandma over at Withering Oaks. We got to get a little time in, bless her heart, before she croaks. And I was just sitting by the TV, smoking cigarettes, drinking Cokes. And I got to watch the end of this game, see if Romo chokes. Now I ain't going nowhere. Ha! Did she liquor me up? And I was totally down. I said, you can be the queen, honey, just bring me the crown. Bring me the crown, baby. I'm getting drunk at the old folks' home tonight.
Hell yeah.
I might steal a walker, maybe pick a fight. Ooh, would you liquor me up?
Yes, she did.
Oh, she liquor me up.
Yes, she did.
All right, she liquor me up.
Yes, she did.
And she liquor me up.
I got a. I buy harmonicas. This is a little pro tip. If you're a harmonica player, buy them fairly, like often, or repair them or something. Because I buy them about once every 10 years, and I don't repair them or anything, and they end up sounding terrible.
I just go to Goodwill. Is that what you get your harmonicas?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Goodwill.
That's how I've caught at least 6 diseases.
Yeah. Yeah.
But
it's cheap harmonicas.
Cheap harmonicas though. Yeah.
Are you Are you brushing your harmonicas?
Brushing them with a toothbrush?
Yeah.
No, that's a great idea, though. I haven't thought of that.
Just, I don't know if that works.
Sure. It's worth a shot.
It's worth a
shot. Okay. Anyway, but the easiest way to go around with a bad harmonica is just tell everybody it's a bad harmonica beforehand instead of having to spend the money on a good one. You
right.
know what I mean?
Yeah.
So anyway, this song goes out to all the people who couldn't make it here tonight, all the ugly folks. Is everybody here? Screw those guys, right?
Yeah. You guys are looking hot.
I thought there'd be a couple of them show up. Thank God they didn't.
Well, and it was on the day we met. It was on the internet. And I asked her for a little photograph. Yeah, she sent it on over to me. Said, I know it's ugly. And I said, girl, ugly ain't the habit. Look at you. Well, you got blue teeth and you only got 2 teeth, but I kinda like to see you smile. And it appears that over the years you've turned into a big old steaming pile. And she said, yeah, I know I ain't no supermodel. I said, you ain't a hand model, baby. Oh, but that's fine.
That's fine.
That's fine. Cause you're pretty ugly by most people's standards. Hey, but you're all right by mine. Yeah. That was on our first date. I showed up right about 8. And she came to the front door. I said, I'm gonna wait right here while you go put on a little makeup. And she said, do I need to put on more? And I was like, yeah, you probably ought to.
Yeah.
Cause you got that one crazy eye and that one haze over the lazy eye. But I kinda dig that ugly grin. Or maybe it's your dermatitis, girl. Or maybe it's your gingivitis. Either way, none of my friends are asking about your twin. She said, yeah. Well, I know I ain't no supermodel. I said, I ain't gonna argue with that, baby, but that's fine.
Baby, that's fine.
Fine. Cause you're pretty ugly by most people's standards. Hey, but you're all right by mine. Maybe I never told her that she looks pretty. Hey, but you can never say I lied. And maybe she's ridiculously hideous to look at, y'all. Hey, but that's just on the outside, yeah. She got them blue teeth, and she only got 2 teeth. But I kinda dig that ugly grin. Even though she looked like she fell straight off a dirt bike and landed right on her chin. Like 8 or 9 times, she said, I know I ain't no supermodel. I said, at least you're self-aware, baby, and that's fine.
Yeah, that's fine.
That's fine. Cause you're pretty damn ugly by most people's standards. Hey, but you're all right by mine. She said, yeah, I know I ain't no supermodel. I said, hell, that's a ridiculous understatement.
Yeah, that's fine.
Cause you're pretty damn ugly by most folks' standards. Hey, But you're all right, bye. Yeah, you're all right, bye. You're all right, bye. You're all right, bye, man.
Cheers, thank you.
Can we get do we have music?
We should start the show with some music.
Yeah, all right, how about this? This is going to be great. This is also totally part of the show.
It already is great.
We're gonna start by playing our theme song, and it would be amazing if everybody here in the crowd humored us by cheering. As if there wasn't this whole awkward interstitial.
You know what, actually, or if my mic was on.
Or if Brian's mic was on.
Imagine all, it's the universe is yours to imagine.
So here we go. In the booth, are we good for music?
Okay, here we go. Shh, everybody close your eyes. Close your eyes. I want you to imagine.
Not yet, God damn it. No, God damn it.
Everybody close your eyes.
I swear to God, this never happens. Do you want to just watch a movie?
Eyes closed. I want you to imagine that you're at the raddest bar on 6th Street. I want you to imagine you just saw the Possum Posse.
Possum Posse.
And I want you to imagine you hear the dulcet tones
of
Kissinger's Vicario playing, which means the show's gonna start and it happens right now. Shut that! You play that fucking music.
Hey! There
we go. We are live in Austin, Texas, which means it's gotta be go time for Night Attack, bringing the best of the internet right here in the middle of the day in 2016. I'm Ryan Rushwood here in Austin, Texas. Joining me right next to me is Justin Robert Young.
Hi. Oh my God! This is a totally normal show. This is how we do all of our shows. Where we're in a bar, and it's not night, it's the day, invalidating the name of the podcast. The Possum Posse hang like vengeful specters over our shoulders.
Can we hear it for the Possum Posse, guys?
One more time.
Got a live house band. South by Southwest is a big deal. I feel like we gotta finally bring it.
This is the first time we've ever done a live show at South by Southwest.
Well, I mean, except for all the other times.
No, we've done concerts.
Yes.
Right? We've done meetups.
We broke world records.
We broke world records at Stubbs.
We did magic shows. We did magic shows.
Right? That happened.
Yeah.
We've never done, in all the incarnations of our podcast.
Yeah.
Because we get around. we've never done just this, just us talking to people at a live show.
So here's the question, man, is do you want to take a moment, go down memory lane?
Let's go. We'll sing the memory lane jingle everybody knows.
Okay. Can we get the memory lane song?
Yeah, just a little memory lane.
It's a slow kind of jam.
Here we go. So let's just go ahead.
Christ,
everybody can sing along, too, since it's so well known.
It's a bit we do all the time. Oh,
here it is. Memory lane. Memory lane, everybody knows the song. Memory lane, that's it.
The
right?
bit yeah. ain't lame.
Oh shit!
Unless it's a
no, those were the secret lyrics. Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, they were lost in the Dead Sea Scrolls.
That's on me.
Jesus was like, anyway, there were these other lyrics that I wrote to the Memory Lane song.
So 2008, man, we were live at Stubbs Barbecue. I did the magic show. We broke world records with your friend of mine from.
Anybody remember the Sky Five? Yeah. Anybody here for that?
These guys are fans of.
I don't
Sky
know,
Fives.
Man. I feel like South by Southwest. You know, South by Southwest used to be all like this. Hey, it's a cool time, everybody, and now it's all like this. Buy a Sony.
I mean, that's funny, because I always thought it was like bleep, blop, blurk, future.
Yeah. And then it was what?
Bleep Blork Nord.
Well, I mean, do you think it's changed South By? Do you think that that South By is something different now than what
no,
it was when we first started
cares?
It?
Look. South By Southwest was awesome, invaded by salespeople, and now the awesome people have taken it back over. That's what I feel like.
Good. We've taken it back, awesome people. We raise a hearty cheer.
So I'll tell you what. I feel like we got to get some guests up here. Can
we
get
do.
Ladies and gentlemen, is Mr. Tomas Merritt in the house? Tom Merritt.
Tom Merritt, everybody. Let's get him up here.
Tom Merritt, if you're unfamiliar, is the host of the Daily Tech News Show at DTNS. You're sitting on some books there. Are those giveaways? What's going on?
Yeah, I'm sitting on books.
Right on.
Why?
It's not because he's self-conscious about his height, if that's what you're thinking.
Okay, can we have some real talk for a minute? I don't know if you realize this. If you go back, here's an Easter egg hunt for all you guys.
Yeah.
It's almost Easter.
If you look at any episode of Scam School shot in the first 4 years that we've done it, you will notice in the wide shot that I'm sitting on my foot. Like, I don't want to be...
At the bar and on the street. You're sitting
on my foot.
At the bar and on your foot.
In fact, I will...
Let's all do
buy
it.
My book, Cheats, Cons, Swindles,
this
and Booster Seats.
This is definitely
seats.
Not going to end with me falling down, by the way. This is going to be great.
Oh, yeah.
I definitely...
Contortionist.
It's fine. But
this
like,
is like Cirque du Soleil. This is great.
And it's like, you'll notice oftentimes that I'm doing the opening bit, the trick itself on my left foot, and then my left foot falls asleep. So I switch after the break to my right foot.
Really?
No, this is legit.
Oh, I see.
To be honest, if I could, I would fucking show up with three phone books. And then,
wait, what was that?
Why couldn't you?
If you're unfamiliar with the podcast, we have a thing called the belt. Brian has now won the belt by cursing. He will have the belt until somebody else curses.
Do we have the actual belt?
I think we do. Somebody's got the belt in the house. Brian's going to have to hold it. It will be his literal cross to bear, except it's not a cross.
But my point
or a bear.
Point is that I'm a coward and I'm very uncomfortable with my height.
No, I'm with you on this. This is great.
Yeah, I should.
Tom's taller than me, and I'm just like, how's the weather down there?
Right,
Dick.
Yeah, I'll just straighten up.
You see, now I started in an unofficial arms race because now.
No, it's a foot race.
Knows my secret.
It is
they're
a foot race.
Sit on their foot.
Yeah. No, I'm not going back. I listen, you've shown me the light. This is great.
For now. Wait till that foot falls asleep.
Exactly. Oh, no, bring the belt.
The belt is here.
Well, I'll tell you what, we also have a very special guest. He hasn't been on the show in a while. He is always a treasured member of our South by Southwest antics. Let's go ahead and bring up Owen J.J. Stone, a.k.a. O-Doctor.
O-Doctor!
You're so intimidating.
The natural gear of the person who is a germaphobe.
I am incognito. I'm not supposed to be here right now. So witness protection and all that. If you refer to an O-Doctor name and stop using
cheap.
My government name,
I'd
appreciate that.
The obvious connection in this show over its years has been, you know, Justin and I, but I feel like the secret thread has always been O-Doctor because O-Doctor was there at the show in New York City.
Yeah.
And then said white people are crazy. Then
someone asked me how we met and I could not figure it out. And I realized like, it was from the show?
Yeah.
Like,
and then,
that's
and then
so
I,
weird.
I gave a panelist out myself.
I was going to say, can you please decamp from the least popular skin in Call of Duty that you are pretending to be? That
look,
is good.
Man, look, when you're important like I am, you can't roam these streets without covering your face. You wanted me to get here on time, right?
Sure.
Oh, doctor. It's a big deal.
That is a thing.
I wanna give you
people always yell about you. So Owen has been here since the very beginning.
Since before the beginning. He's the alpha.
I'm one of the original super friends.
Yeah, you're
I'm
Black,
like after
Black Bolton.
Yeah,
in the beginning was O-Doctor, and
in the beginning it was Brett. I came after Brett.
Yeah, but we ditched his ass.
Yeah. He's got like
everybody,
a life now.
Everybody, can we get a one big cheer for Brett? Or we can boo him. It's up to you. You can either cheer or boo. But here we go on the count of three. One, two, three.
Boo.
Sounds 50-50. Sounds 50-50.
He's out there being an adult and
I
having
know.
A
He's
life and
have
a family.
Look at that.
All right, look,
horrible.
We have a rare opportunity here.
Uh-huh.
We have an all-star cast. We also have...
Do we not have another
the first
mic?
Time, I don't know if you noticed, but it's been like 2 or 3 months since we've had a sponsor.
Yeah. Ads, much like people who are caught unsuspecting when a podcast broke out at this Brew Exchange...
Correct.
...have fled from our program because of our inconsistency and naughty language. However, we do have a return. The prodigal son has returned.
All right. This is one of the few times in the entire planet this is going to happen.
Yeah.
I'm going to mention a brand that is specifically targeted to high-end corporate enterprise-level customers.
Sure.
Coke.
And people at a bar are going to go nuts. Any of y'all guys hear about a little thing called Mail Round?
Oh,
is that the Mail Route theme song coming up?
Yeah.
I feel like it's time.
We decided that we were going
to write a song.
We got the lyrics right here.
Killing that spam.
Go ahead.
All day long. IT departments need to do no more, but with less money in 2016.
This includes really important stuff like stopping spam and virus attacks and making email available 24/7.
Oh, shit. End of life announcements for trusted hardware and software options make these decisions just a little more difficult to you and me.
I need you, one of you needs to do a whip crack. Try MailRoute. MailRoute will protect your email and hardware against spam, viruses, and other attacks, and they provide 24/7 mailbox continuity.
Hey man, there ain't no need for hardware or software to install if you own your domain. That's all you need to use MailRoute.
MailRoute's team focuses exclusively on email protection since 97. Their interface is easy to use and loaded with admin tools. Anybody into admin tools? Including an API that stands for Awesome People Incorporated.
It's designed to make your life better by eliminating your betters.
Stop spam today with a free 30-day trial. Go to mailroute.net/nightattack.html.
All right, I feel like we need like one hook.
We do. Well, we need. How about we just hear the? Oh, here we go. Wait.
One more time.
One more time. Let's just do the URL.
All right. mailroute.net/nightattack.html.
mailroute.net. Nightattack.html.
I fucked it up.
Mailroute.net. Nightattack.html. Mailroute.net. Nightattack.html. Mailroute.net. Nightattack.html.
Oh, look at him go.
Freestyle.net.
Nightattack.html.
Mailroute.net.
Nightattack.html. Okay, for the record.
I'm working on a new dance move. I want everybody, thank you, Owen. I want everybody to get in on it. It's called the Vengeful Spider. Can you just give me that bass line one more time? This is the new dance move I'm working on. It's called the Vengeful Spider. Describe it for the audio.
Audio listener, it looks
like... It's like he's got 8 legs.
Cowboy is stuck in the mud, trying to step out.
That's a little something for the live audience.
It's fine. Holy cow. Ladies and gentlemen, live in the audience, your friend of mine, Miss Tay Alley.
Yeah, everybody give it up for Tay.
Yeah!
Brian, there's a bit we've been building to.
This has been the main event, and I don't know if everyone should appreciate or what's going on.
Yeah, we have Tom's got a big announcement.
I got three things.
Three things.
I got
three things.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, I didn't know you brought an agenda to our comedy podcast.
Yeah, you brought a comedy podcast to my agenda.
Oh, man.
Well,
I have no agenda.
What?
Copyrighted.
Copyright Adam Curry. Sorry.
And the globalists have struck
again. All
right,
so real quick, anybody want a free book? Oh, yeah? This is the first of the Sword and Laser Collection science fiction novels by J.F. Debeau, The Life Engineered, about the Capex, a rise of artificial creatures 30,000 years after the end of humanity.
I got this, Tom. What y'all know about science fiction literature? Y'all in the robots! Woo! Y'all in the space!
Woo!
Then this book by J.F. Dubose, the life engineer, is gonna blow your mind!
Woo!
The first person to raise their hand gets a copy. Raise your hand! Oh, that hit somebody.
That was a lie.
All right, the first person to yell a song titled gets another book.
I heard Free Bird. I heard Free Bird.
There we go. You better watch out. Oh, there we go.
Also, I am literally the only one still sitting on his foot.
All right.
Y'all couldn't hang.
I couldn't. You're a pro.
So real quick, if I could say something.
Hold on, wait a minute. No. Tom's got a real big announcement.
Tom has a really good, important announcement. But just so everybody knows, I have acquired all rights to Tom Merritt, his patrons, his shows, his wife.
Is this true?
Tom Merritt. We negotiated a deal last night. I'm so glad to announce.
I don't remember anything about last night.
Time out.
So everybody knows.
Listen,
finish your announcement,
I don't want to be too professional here, but I'd like to do what they call a tease.
Yeah.
By the way, the tease sting is what they're about to play right now.
The tease sting.
Hey guys,
I had one of those.
I have a tease. It's good enough. That's great.
That's great. I really feel like it teased it out a little bit, right?
I teased your tease out.
So here's the
do you have a tease?
No, I do, but it's okay. Can we just Let's tease
your big
announcement.
Yes.
In the meantime, can we take a moment to talk about a fan of the show, a friend of ours for a long time?
Yeah.
And maybe we could write a song about it, but it's somebody who's better than me. Because me, I'm too chicken to mess with my body. Every time there's a scar, I get upset. There's somebody better than me that says, my body is a husk. It is a paperback novel. And the best thing you can do to that paperback novel is cover it in doodles and scrawls that tell the story of your life.
Absolutely.
So that by the time you leave it behind, this empty husk burns away.
Yeah.
Covered in your adventures and experiences.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want everybody to please give a warm welcome to the stage one of the most near and dear member of our Diamond Club family. Ladies and gentlemen, Crunchy!
Crunchy!
Come on up. All right, you're going to stand right here. Brian's going to remain sitting on his foot, so he illustrates how much taller he is.
I just want to show how tall I am, but see, Crunchy's a little bit shorter. I can...
Yeah.
All right, I'm sitting.
I know all this is the story of my life.
Okay, real quick, for those of you guys who did not tune in a few weeks ago, we got a phone call from a very concerned, beautiful young woman who had an outrageous and controversial idea for a tattoo. After much discussion, I would like to think that we added to...
We did.
...the idea this
year. Yeah. So what was your... What was your initial idea?
Your initial idea...
The initial idea, somebody showed us a tattoo of he had a tattoo of a woman shitting, like, on his chest plate.
Tay Allen shouting, it happens, in the audience.
Making it too real, Tay. Okay, no, stop making it real.
I thought it was hilarious, and I jokingly said I was going to get a tattoo of a guy coming on my face. Which I can't do because I like having
on
a job.
Your face.
I feel like that was Mike Tyson's original design before he went with the tribal. It's like 50-50. I don't know. But that obviously is a non-starter because you have a job.
But you had a follow-up idea.
Not for any other reason.
Your follow-up idea was
we thought of other places that this was a popular activity, like inner thighs and all that. And then I realized that the lower back for like a tramp stamp was pure poetry.
Well, I mean, it has been called a bullseye, a target.
Sure, yeah. On bumper stickers and beach t-shirts the world over.
So the question is, how does one elegantly and cleverly get a tattoo on their lower back of a giant cock ejaculating on it?
Yeah, that's the million-dollar question. I feel like, so have you taken action on this?
Yes, and first of all, it's not a giant cock. And, it looks big on me. In real life, it's a 3 or 4-inch cock. It's not...
Am I right, ladies?
I mean, you realize from this day forward, there's going to be an awkward
that
moment.
That penis just sat on its foot to look bigger.
It's like, there's going to be, in every intimate encounter, there'll be a moment where it's like, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, wait, hold on. Well, it's a little smaller.
Yeah.
Close enough.
Although now it would just feel hack. It's like, well, she's already called it out. Like, you know, now I got to do something interesting. Like,
all right, so here's the thing. And now, you originally had the idea of just having it. Tell me if I remember this correctly. It was on the phone call that we had the idea to keep the wiener, wienery, but the ejaculate to be UV reactive?
Yes.
All right. Now, we don't know how well this is going to work, and if you are an audio listener, then you need to watch this on YouTube, our video version. Oh, my God. She has...
She came prepared.
She has a black light. We also have a black light right over there.
We have a gigantic... By the way, I can only imagine that Crunchy, if you are lucky enough to engage in sexual congress with Crunchy, she just hands you, like, a black light flashlight...
By the
and
way,
a wet nap, and you're like, all right, things are getting serious.
For the record, I mean, I don't want to limit this to Crunchy. If any woman is about to engage in sexual congress and hands you a black light, you know you're in for something good.
Yes.
Or she's committed murder and she's trying to let you know.
You guys, stop ruining the magic.
I have black light tattoos on my feet, and that's why I carry it.
Yeah.
Of course.
Well, oddly enough, if you now have this new one, so would you like to show it to the audience?
Let's do the cheapest pop ever.
Yeah.
How many of y'all want to see a dick on her backside? Say yeah!
I think that's more than 50.
Yeah.
That's pretty cheap pop.
All right, here we go. Let's go ahead and get the cameras here.
We need some music
here. I am now beginning the black light.
hold off the black light.
All right.
How recently did this happen, by the way?
What?
How recently did you get this done?
This is 4 days ago.
4 days ago.
4 days ago, ladies. Let's, encouragement.
Oh my god!
That is amazing!
She has a real tattoo of a dick shoot.
Let's go on! Crunchy! What? No! But now, like, Crunchy just left the stage with her head down.
Show's over.
As if.
Shut it
Something
down.
Happened, the metaphor for which I can't understand or describe.
As soon as you're done, roll over and go to sleep. That's how we do it.
I gotta be honest, my favorite part was that only half the band was playing because the other half of the band walked up and just stood up.
We were waiting for
I did both. I did both. I walked up and
played. He did both.
You guys built it up so much, I'm like, I'm not gonna
That was
miss this.
Astonishing. One more time for Crunchy, ladies.
Yeah, Crunchy!
She's a living CSI episode. It's amazing.
I mean, the good news, or the bad news, rather, is that, like, you know, to pull off that trick, you got to make sure that you change those sheets, right? Like, you know, you don't want a stray blacklight ray to be like, oh, well, that's funny. Oh, God. Oh, geez. It is a commitment to hygiene. Anyway, right. Tom, what was your announcement?
So I'm getting a tattoo.
Is it as good as the tattoo?
Tom's going to show off his own back tattoo, but it's for...
I'm sorry, you're not doing this correctly. All right,
I'm sorry.
Real quick, give me something dramatic that we could do. Cut it here. Ladies and gentlemen, you've seen lower back tattoos with UV-activated ejaculate ink.
Ejaculate.
You've seen Tom Merritt give tech news. Daily. But you won't believe what comes next.
Literally.
So to speak. Go ahead, Tom.
All right. Any of you like tech news? Yeah. So Daily Tech News Show is a lie. That's what I'm here to say.
What?
It is entirely a lie. We're only on 6 days a week. It's not
six,
daily. But we're going to fix that lie.
What? Hold on. Finally going to do something about it.
Tom, I'm sorry. We didn't discuss this.
Yeah, come
on. That's messed up, man.
You're giving away the farm, man.
Look, you realize that.
Seven days?
The only way to do a seventh day is if you were to sum up the week's news.
Well, I'm not God, so I'm not going to rest on the seventh day.
Not God, because he had shots fired at him.
What we're going to do, for those of you who like Daily Tech News Show, we're going to add a new milestone after we get day six hit. If we get $1,000 more past the day six milestone, we will do one monthly roundtable episode on Saturdays.
Sure.
If we get that accomplished, we'll go set another milestone for two, and then three, and then four, and finally get rid of the lie.
Yes. It'll indeed be a Daily Tech News Show. Just so we.
Yes.
The Camelot.
Exactly.
Just so y'all understand, what this means is a roundtable show featuring all the Daily Tech News Show contributors as a rotating cast.
Yeah.
That brings a weekly tech news show to the Daily Tech News Show umbrella. This is pretty awesome, right?
Thank you.
If you haven't followed and support patreon.com/DTNS, please do it right now.
More details to come there shortly.
Man, it's going to be super rad. I'm pumped for it.
Hey, Tom.
Yeah, Brian.
Have you ever seen like a tattoo of a dick shooting cum on a backside?
Oddly enough, I was very close to one once, but I couldn't see it.
You couldn't see it?
Yeah, because I was.
Show the band.
And I was stupid enough not to get up and just take two steps and look.
Yeah.
I mean, half the band did. I
know.
I don't understand why you didn't.
I got muscled out of the way.
Do you want to see it?
Can we move on to our big event?
We have been building up for the last 4 weeks. We have never planned anything for 4 weeks straight. this is a bit that you guys invented. Chat Realm and Diamond Club invented. Called.
We of course have to sing the theme song.
Oh, of course, yeah. We can get this is a rollicking theme song, an adventurous theme song.
I mean, it's like, you know, we only have one thing. We just say the theme over again. Ready?
Oh yeah. Yeah.
30 seconds. We're dying of fire. 30 seconds. We're dying of fire.
It's a fire.
We're dying of fire.
It's a fire.
30 seconds. We're dying of fire. 30 seconds. We're dying of fire.
30 seconds.
Oh, we just died
in a fire.
God, can we join a band? This is so easy.
This is. Who knew? The Possum Posse. One more time.
Possum Posse. Yeah.
So here's how it's gonna work. We'll go one by one.
Oh, jeez.
We have these two bins. These are all suggestions.
Two fish bowls.
Two fish bowls.
Sample containers.
In one is a challenge.
Yeah, but what looks to be a container that you'd be given with an adult magazine in a bank for fertility.
So here's the game, is we're going to open both one at a time, and we can choose to either do a challenge for 30 seconds, or we could choose to die in a fire. They are very different solutions. The dying in a fire is the scarier of the
two.
Okay,
so I'm going to pick one. Brian's going to pick one.
Right, first of all, who are we competing for? What are we doing?
Yeah, we're doing it as tribute?
Let's do Owen. Owen, we're going to present two alternatives.
Two options. You choose.
One is 30 seconds. The other is a die in a fire.
It's a lot of pressure.
Yeah. Are you ready?
I'm not ready.
Too bad. Here we go. Here's your challenge.
No, that's the die in a fire.
I'm setting you up.
The challenge is crumble a newspaper sheet with one hand in 30 seconds. Attempt to do that.
All right. Or...
if that's too difficult.
Yeah, okay. Or you can take the die in a fire option, wear a shock collar and bark.
Jesus.
So if you don't complete the challenge, you have to die in a fire, wear a shock collar, and bark. Or you can just take this if you want, because it'd be really popular.
Darker than I thought.
First of all, I feel as though this was a setup.
Totally free choice.
Second of all, it wasn't free choice.
For me.
Yes, for you it's a free choice. I will take said newspaper crumbling if I do not complete it. Someone in the audience takes my challenge over for me.
Okay.
Who will stand?
Yeah.
Oh, jeez, right. That's
wow.
A lot.
Wow, look at that. Yeah. Look at that.
What?
All right, I saw right over here up front. What's your name, sir? Yeah. What's that?
Chuck.
Everyone,
Chuck, round of applause.
Chuck.
Whoever booed me can die in a fire.
Chuck.
I'm involving Chuck.
You got this.
I got this.
30 seconds.
Chuck seems a little bit desperate as he says that.
Rolls. One hand, I put it in a ball.
Wait a minute. All right, here we go. Timer.
Yeah, one hand in a ball.
Here we go. And begin. Whoa. You put it up against your leg.
Stop. He won. He won.
He won.
Wait, what's the ruling here? What's the ruling here?
One hand.
Saw a ball.
All right. You don't think that that's a violation?
Interesting. Judges,
don't get me wrong. I would love to shock someone, but he won fair and square.
Give me another sheet. I'll do it without my leg.
Oh.
Oh.
Next all
right.
Time, all right, ready.
Time, when someone asks you a question, you answer the question. I ask for the rules.
All right. One, two, three, go.
Keep going tighter. You are the Deion Sanders of crumbling paper.
No, kidding.
You are showboating.
Less than 10 seconds.
Doctor, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm a professional. Chuck
all right,
was never
Chuck,
in
you're good. You're good.
Chuck was never in danger. I love you, Chuck. Everybody
all right.
Else, Dynamite.
Tom Merritt.
Yes, sir.
All right. From the challenge category, you have been given the following. Pitch the Night Attack podcast in 30 seconds. Success or failure will be determined by the audience's response.
Yes.
Okay. All right.
If you fail to do so correctly, you will have to DIAF.
And that is a tequila and mouthwash rinse for 30 seconds.
I mean, look, I don't think it's cool to sculpt the audience's expectations.
No.
But I am going to say that were they all to boo, the second part would be really entertaining to
yeah.
me.
I mean, we gotta pay off this bit, guys.
Right. Would it be disqualified if one had already done the DIF as a normal part of their morning routine?
Oh, calm down, Kesha.
Pixar, we didn't see it. Pixar didn't happen.
All right, your challenge. Pitch the Night Attack podcast in 30 seconds, beginning in 5.
All right, and go.
Night Attack. It's two comedians, one from Florida, one from Scandinavia, and then a Texas. They
Wait,
tell
on, you
about.
Open up your phone again.
What's that?
I accidentally closed it, so I can't see the time.
Yeah. Pause.
One interrupts you while you're trying to pitch his goddamn podcast.
Go.
Okay, 18 seconds, 19.
Two comedians. They talk about dicks a lot and dying in a fire. You must watch them and join the Diamond Club, or you will be left behind by society, and the robots will eat your brain.
And that's time. All right, so here we go. Round applause-o-meter.
Yeah. If you hate the idea of him dying in a fire, then
Wait a minute. No.
seems like you didn't do so great.
If you love the idea of him dying in a fire, make some noise.
Worst audience ever.
Man, how quickly they turn.
All right.
Where was Chuck when I needed him?
I seem...
You should have voted to Chuck before.
Tom, it seems as if your pitch was not successful. Don't worry.
It seems that way, doesn't it?
Don't worry, it's not the first nor the last time that people have been not enthusiastic about a pitch for Night Attack. We need a shot of tequila from the bar.
Yeah, wait. By the way, this is a great moment to remind everyone that we are live at the Brew Exchange on 6th Street. Woo! Or as I like to call it, Ayn Rand's Cream Dream, a place where market conditions reign supreme.
Be sure to pick a tequila that goes with fresh mint.
By the way, Breckenridge Vanilla Porter going for $6.75 right now on the live ticker. Stone IPA, $5.25.
512-128-725.
What is what are your thoughts going through your mind right now? You have unfortunately died in a fire.
I am being consumed by the flames of tequila and Listerine, and it is beautiful.
Have you ever gargled tequila before?
No.
Dude,
I mean,
okay.
Just asking.
Question: do we gargle or does he just go?
Is it rinse? The word was rinse.
A rinse, you
yeah.
swallow.
Yeah, no. So
rinse
we're
doesn't
gonna...
mean I'm not swallowing this.
No, you have to swallow.
Oh,
you have to
swallow. Shizzle.
All right, so that's gonna be your spit cup there.
So who,
I'll tell you what.
You're gonna bartender, set me up with a Listerine and tequila,
here's what
please.
You're gonna do. As you wash, we're gonna sing the Listerine wash song.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah.
And it'll build to a crescendo.
I mean, what's great is I didn't have to use cheesecloth to get the alcohol out of this.
Right.
So.
And then
Listerine and tequila.
Oh, man.
This is good. Audio listeners, you're
wow,
looking at.
Wow, a very odd hue. It looks like a beautiful sunset, actually.
It really does. That's what this is called, a beautiful sunset.
All right, we begin for 30 seconds. Here
All
we
right.
go. And go.
Listerine tequila. Listerine tequila. Listerine tequila. Listerine tequila. Listerine tequila. Listerine tequila. Swallow, 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 swallow.
That was a test.
Pussy, you can't see. Pussy, pussy.
Go, go, go. 30 seconds. 30 seconds. He's beyond 30 seconds.
Listerine tequila.
He's now just showing off. We're at 42 seconds, ladies and gentlemen.
It's too easy. It's too easy.
All right, just seriously, now swallow.
Oh! Oh!
Tom Merritt is a grown-ass man.
Anybody else want the beautiful sunset?
He said 30 seconds. What's that? It matters to me. I'm an adult.
Oh my God.
Do what I want to do.
So good.
Oh my God.
That was good.
Do you feel more of a man?
I feel like anyone should try it. Please help yourself.
Yeah, no, it's being passed around the audience now.
It definitely adds a fresh twist.
Wow. It turns out this became a real mixology podcast.
I could kiss you, Tom.
And my gums feel so good.
So delicious.
All right, Brian. It's my turn.
Right, buddy.
It's my turn.
All right, here we go.
Right now.
Here.
Justin's.
You
want to
pick
turn.
One for me? Right. Pick one for me.
All right.
So I can't cheat.
The challenge to you, Justin Robert Young, pick randomly. By the way, can we give a huge shout out to Bryce and Brandt for being our amazing producers?
They're great. I love them both.
All right, Justin.
Yeah.
You're going to have to do this or
please
die
be
in a
the
fire.
Please be the vengeful spider.
Let another person search through your text message history.
Oh. Wow.
Or.
Take off your shirt and run around the block for 5 minutes.
Oh, man.
I'm actually lying. That's what I just made up. It actually says another person plucked 10 hairs from your head, which isn't as fun as what I just
Another person plucked 10 hairs from his head?
Yes.
Yeah, what's it going to be,
my
Justin?
My shirt running thing was better. I didn't want to cheat. Can I read the text messages? Because I just want to know.
Man. The text message thing is like dying in a fire.
Sexy. If you just want to find some text messages.
Oh, my God. Oh,
is it a dramatic reading?
Yeah, that's what
I'm
thinking.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You know, it's like we can tell a story here.
Oh, man.
Man, I feel like it should be our text messages.
Yeah.
But I'm worried about what's in there.
I mean, like, I feel like I need
read that one.
I need to have the hairs plucked from my head to protect confidence of other people.
You don't have to read the person's name.
I mean,
no, but like one person just like literally used his last name and said somebody in his family's voting for Trump. So like, that's not appropriate.
Wait, find a conversation with me or Tom or me.
Oh, Jesus.
Ah, ha, ha, ha.
Oh, man, none of these work.
Oh,
these
really?
Are all, yeah.
Well, I guess there's
all right, I guess I gotta get the hairs plucked from my very...
Wow!
The hairs plucked from his very bald... No, it's...
All right, Okay, so...
How scandalous is his cell phone?
Here's what we're gonna do.
From my beard!
Yeah, since you pumped out...
Beard.
Since you pumped out...
Here's what I wanna
five
do.
Five from your beard, five from your head.
We are gonna do all the right. official Night wow. Attack... Beard plucking song.
Oh God!
Of course, well known, big hit in Pakistan.
Five of us will get a hand on one hair.
Oh my God!
And it doesn't have to be a beard; it could be all over his body.
And oh, then, all over my body.
Oh, Jesus. Keep going, keep going. No,
even
keep
Bryce going. Was like, "No,
this is happening."
Let loose the juice.
All right, turn around, turn around. All right. Here, you take this. We need five people to grab individual hairs from Justin Young.
Ah, this and turned into a whole different bit suddenly.
All right, on the hit, we're going to go through 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and on the hit, each of us will yank 1, 2, 3.
This is all going to be back
pulling
hair.
Pulling all those hairs onto the floor. We're making this motherfucker bald. We don't care what the law says. All right, hold on. All right, ready? All right, hold on. I need more people to get a hand on it. Bonnie, come over here. Get my wife on this. Owen.
Oh, my
grab
God.
Grab another man's hair.
This is the definitely
another,
a nightmare.
Hair.
This
another
is a literal
hair.
Nightmare.
Grab another man's hair. Stacy, get in on this.
This is a Cronenberg movie.
All right, here we go. Ready?
I'm sorry,
oh
Ashley.
Oh, my God.
We're going to go. We're going to go clockwise.
Jesus.
Clockwise starting at me. Ready? Oh, y'all motherfuckers here at Brew Exchange. Ready for
the
hair.
Just do it!
Yeah, wait, don't talk. Gonna yank your hair.
What count are we at?
3, 2, 1, yank. 3, 2, 1, yank. Who's got...
We're not.
2, 1, yank.
Go!
All right, one more. Who loves a slightly balder? Let's hear it for slightly more bald, Justin.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, I wanted that jam to keep going. Bonnie.
Execution.
You want a challenge? You want
Bonnie
to take a challenge?
Bonnie wants a challenge.
I mean, you're right here.
Bonnie never shrinks from a challenge.
Bonnie Brushwood.
Oh, where's the Diana Fire?
Your challenge.
I feel violated. I'm gonna join a support group. That was thank you, Stacy.
Bonnie Brushwood, your challenge is to do a dance blindfolded for 30 seconds. Or your
do
Diana
a dance
Fire.
Blindfolded or
if you don't want to do that, Bonnie Brushwood, you have to take two shots of soy sauce.
All right, blindfolded dance or two shots of soy sauce. Bonnie, what's going through your head?
I'm thinking that I can probably dance in a way that the audio listeners can appreciate.
Wow, nice.
This is like a new form of...
So excellent.
All right.
And so tell us a little bit about the dance so we can make the appropriate music.
All right, well, I'm channeling Eileen from the Seinfeld show.
Oh, Jesus.
Any Seinfeld fans in the house?
They're all 20 years dead.
Yeah. All right.
What?
So we need a blindfold.
All right, hold on. She's wrapping
this is gonna
her
look
head.
Like a like the weirdest Al Qaeda training video.
She looks like a sand person from Tatooine. Let me hear your best. All right, here we go. Ready? Coming up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go.
Her name is Bonnie. She is the best. She has a better than the rest. She is the best. She started the timer, so we still have 30 seconds. Oh. You know she's best. She's dancing all around the place. Let's hear it, Brew Exchange. Woo! Dance, Bonnie, dance. audience.
Ladies and gentlemen, Bonnie Rushwood!
Well, shit.
Brian, this is all built to this moment.
God damn it.
You now have... Oh, hell no. Get your filthy fingers out of there. Here's the way that you can scam your way out of the bid.
Son of a bitch.
All right. Where's the challenge? Owen is now selecting the challenge here.
The alternate.
No, I have the DIAF.
Okay.
Owen, what is Brian's challenge?
Style your hair with
an entire tube of gel.
An entire tube of gel?
Of gel.
I mean, that should be easy for you.
I mean, that's like a life skill. Iceman.
Oh, no,
cover
Owen.
Yourself in ice.
Oh, Owen, wait a minute. That one burn up. It's not valuable anymore. This one is the new replacement.
Another person dust any three of your headstone cards.
Your hearthstone.
Hearthstone cards.
You can dust any three. If somebody else selects hearthstone cards to dust. If you're not familiar, this is effectively like asking somebody to choose which of Brian's children gets sent away
on
the slow boat.
Or,
I mean, I want to remind everybody that Brian plays Paladin. Or, you could have a Sriracha facial for 30 seconds. And I'm going to interpret this, I'm going to interpret facial the way I want.
I assume a massaging, wrinkle reducing.
Nope.
All right, I'll take the sriracha feel.
Oh!
Wow! Wow!
Crunchy, get here.
The cards are worth that much to him.
Yeah, they are.
Get to pick.
All right.
Oh, jeez.
No, get on your knees.
What? Listen, I love and respect you. I wouldn't let just anyone do this to me.
Crunchy is going to give Brian the facial. For no reason.
30 seconds. God damn it. All right. Swear to God, this better be a good song guys
play. Hold on, wait, we're getting a cloth.
Payback is a witch.
Yeah, let me,
Why don't you just tuck the towel
I'm sure how you always dreamed your career would go.
Ryan, just tuck the towel around the neck.
What?
Yeah, it's gonna get messy, bro. I don't know if you ever given one, but
yeah.
I'm the kind of guy that hits the ceiling occasionally.
Exactly.
I don't know what she's gonna do. But
if not, there's some great documentaries that you should watch about what's about to happen.
Close your eyes and open your mouth and keep your
nose. Squirt that on the floor just to make sure that it's legit.
Eyes closed, mouth open, nose tilted down. I'm just trying to
Show the tat. I'm about to experience the tats. All right,
we are now preparing the sriracha bottle.
Oh, I've always dreamed of a chance to get sriracha faced.
It's gonna be a warm shower.
Ever
just let it glaze you. Let it wash over your face. Know that it's natural from the earth.
All
the
right.
Essence of life.
Now, Crunchy, we gotta put a little bit of art into this. So you need to kind of make sounds as if you're working up to it, no? Okay, I'll fill in.
I'll be your start.
You wanna do it?
Slow,
you wanna do it? Okay.
Kind of build up to a moment, right?
Yeah, all right, so here we go. We're gonna take the band's cue on when things boil over.
All right, here we go.
All right, Owen is going to be our Foley artist, providing the voice.
No.
I want you to feel where I'm coming from.
Listen, I've done a lot of things for this show.
Semen furniture.
All right, here we go.
I never thought it would come to this.
I did. I've been dreaming about this night for a long time, and I'm getting worked up. Let me shake it up a little bit before you run. Play with the balls, baby. Play with the
there
balls.
There was a time Brian was on his knees.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Get a pretty please.
Move,
sriracha facial was what he got. Front mask was on his thoughts. That's enough. Here we go. Face.
Oh, I bet you didn't know that I love Sriracha so much that I sang all live. Got a good face to
Brian
with
Brushwood, ladies and gentlemen.
Everybody knows that Sriracha's made by some Asian people, I guess. Everybody knows Sriracha really sucks when it's in your face and chest. Everybody be polite with your Sriracha. Don't just shoot it in the face. Sriracha. We're sponsored by them.
Let's get some water. Can we get some water? Get some water from the bar. We need to flush his eyes.
I apologize. Swear to God. Excited. It happens.
Man.
The fuck is happening?
Brian.
First time left.
I mean, the goodness.
Oh, shit. Oh, no. Oh, shit.
We need water.
I opened my eyes.
That was a bad idea. Water. Let's get water here. All right. Flush his eyes.
Man, there should be like a podcast that shows how to deal with this.
Yeah. All right. Yeah. Now we are. Wow. This went from like a real fun time to CSI. Like, this is Grey's Anatomy.
The rule is never open your eyes until they're cleared out.
We were at a podcast and we thought we were having fun.
He didn't know.
Yeah. One more time for Brian Brushwood.
Mr. Brian Brushwood.
Thank you, Austin. You guys are the best.
The red mask has never been more spicy than it was here.
Jesus.
Is it burning out? Burning out here?
It's fine.
All right. That's 30 seconds or DIAF. Thank you to everybody who helped us.
Hey, real quick, before the power of sight is returned to me, do we have time for just one more song from the Possum Posse?
I believe that we do. Real quick, Owen, where can people find you?
IQMZ.com, on the internet. I'm everywhere.
Tom?
TomMerritt.com, DailyTechNewsShow.com.
Brian?
You can find him at the ER.
At the emergency room.
That's right. Jesus.
I'm about to give Brian my glasses so you can...
All right, well, here, wait, hold on a minute. You can wear my heart glasses. Now it looks way better.
My eyes are still closed.
Exactly.
I'm not seeing any better.
All right. You can find me, Justin R. Young. Can we get one more big thank you from the live crowd here at the Brew Exchange? Their new album, available now, is Local Motive. Let's go ahead and hear it one more time for the Possum Posse!
Well, one day a guy on a buffalo was riding around in the forest. He didn't see that Indian guy crouching down and he popped off a shotgun. Bang! He fell off his buffalo. The buffalo took off running while the Indian was still reloading. The guy on the buffalo snuck up behind him with a pistol and he was like, hey, that's not cool, man. I'm gonna watch what you're doing. Bam! Guy on a buffalo, breaking your gun on the stump. Don't you wake up, oh no, you don't want to mess with the guy that's riding on a buffalo. Hey Indians, Native Americans, don't mess with the guy that's riding on a buffalo. Then the guy on the buffalo hopped over, stretched his legs and walked around in the field. He was like, hey, what's this in the weeds? It's a baby, a human baby. Cool. Put it in his saddle, hopped on, left it up a hill and across a plain. Tried to cross the river, that didn't happen because he was on a buffalo. Top heavy. Oh, but he kept that baby afloat. Get your guy on a buffalo. You gotta find your friend. Holy shit. She's married. Guy on a buffalo was like, hey, you want this baby? She said it's cheaper than adoption. Guy on a buffalo, you're welcome, lady. But it's high time I move along. I'm a buffalo. See you later, lady. I'm a guy on a buffalo.
he hopped off. Do a little hunt. And the buffalo was like, don't do that by yourself, it's a bad idea. The guy was like, I got this buffalo, it's not a big deal. Yeah. And so normally the buffalo would have his bag, but at that moment he was chewing on some grass in a field. And about the time the guy got ready to shoot, he straight up got mauled by a cougar. Where's that buffalo when I need him? Oh, he's got problems of his own. He's being attacked by a wolf. Got on a buffalo, you're gonna have to just punch a cougar in the face. Get out of here, kitty, can't beat it. And hey, wolf, I got a little something for you. It's a kick from a buffalo. I'm talking about a kick to the face. A kick to the face from a full-grown buffalo.
Dying of fire, people.
See you next Tuesday. That's the end of the podcast. You guys can cheer if you want.
Yeah, no. That was not a threat. We weren't threatening you.
No, that's totally at your own...
Wait, do we have the... pretend... The what?
Yeah.
Diamond Club hopes you've enjoyed this poem. That's your thing.
So we literally... No, I like that. That's good. Okay, you do right, my part, I'll do your part.
Okay, God damn it. All right, yeah. Diamond Club hopes you've enjoyed this production.
Kind of sounds like the Count. One, but two streams of sriracha on my face. Three streams.
By the way, for the record, like we took like a tear gas grenade. And
on the Modern Rogue, yeah.
That was worse. That was
really?
Worse.
Way yeah. worse.
No, for the
You know what I think
the
key difference was? The mask.
Having a mask would have been
turns
better.
It worked out better. Right now, I don't know if y'all saw, I poured sriracha on my face during the thing.
How's that feeling?
Starting to trickle into my eyes.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I mean, if only one of these gentlemen would be so kind as to lick it from your face.
Captain Murphy, ladies and gentlemen.
All right, do you guys have time for one more or do you got a bolt?
We can do one more.
Do y'all want him to do one more?
All right, guys, this is a blues riff and B. Watch me for the changes and try to keep up.
Your kids are going to love it.
Everybody, if you have not purchased Locomotive, they have copies over there on your way out. Buy it on iTunes. Buy it on Amazon. Buy it wherever you buy fine music. It is one of my favorite albums. We got posters, we got buttons, we got contenders in the back. In all seriousness, this means a lot to us that we had so many people come out. So thank you once again for doing that.
And I think we're all thinking the same thing. Jesus Christ, Sriracha's hot stuff. Real hot in your eyes. Don't put it in your eyes, kids.
All right. One more time, let's give it up for the Bossom Bosses!
Well, she take my money when I'm in need. Oh, she's a traveling friend indeed. Yeah, she's a gold digger. Well, over time, she digs on me. She take my money.
I say she's a gold digger.
But
she ain't messing with no broke.
I'm to the tribe.
I say she's a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke. The broke.
She's a gold digger.
Get down, girl, go hang
it
down.
She know you over time.
Get down, girl, go hang it down.
And she digs on me.
Get down, girl, go hang it down. Get down, girl, go hang it down. You see Cutie the Bomb, met her at a beauty salon with a baby Louis Vuitton under her underarm. She said, I can tell you rock, I can tell by your charm. For a girl, you got a flock, I can tell by your charm and your arm. But I'm looking for the one to be seen. It's like a coming, she gon' have an ass like Serena, Trina, Jennifer Lopez. Both kids, I gotta take all they badass to show me. Okay, you got your kid, yeah. Then they got their friends, uh-huh. Pulled up in the Benz, right. And they all got a fit, yes. Maybe y'all went to dick. Okay. And then I had to pay, but if you fucking with this girl, then you better be paid.
Why, Brian?
It takes too much to touch her. And from what I heard, she got a baby by Busta. And my best friend said she used to fuck with Usher. Yeah, but I don't care what none of y'all say.
She take my mind.
I ain't saying she's a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke.
I
ain't saying she's a gold digger. Nah, but she ain't messing with no broke. Get down, girl, go hang it down. Get down, girl, go hang it down. You see, for 18 years, she got one of your kids, got you for 18 years. I know somebody paying child support for one of his kids, and baby's mama going crazy, bigger than his, but you will see him on TV. Any given Sunday, win the Super Bowl, and drive off and under. She was supposed to buy your shorty psycho with your money. She went to the doctor, got lipo with your money. Now she walking around looking like Michael with your money, but you should have got that insurance, Geico, for your money. And if you ain't no punk, you holler, we want prenup!
We want prenup, yeah!
Something that you need to have, cause when she leave your ass, she gonna leave with half. 18 years, and on her 18th birthday,
yeah,
she found out it was his.
Yeah,
she's a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke.
I said the chocolate!
She's a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no
broke.
Get down, girl, go hang it down. Get down, girl, go hang it down. Get down, girl, go hang it down. Get down, girl, go hang it down.
Yo, chest it down!
You got needs, you don't want to do the smoke, but it get my weed. It goes out to eat, it can't pay, you can't leave. The dishes in the back, you gotta roll up a sleeves. But while you're washing, watch him, cause he gon' make it to a pins out of that Dyson. He got that ambition, baby, just look at his eyes. He's licking by the floor, so he's winking the fries. So stick by his side, I know his dude's ballin', yeah, that's nice. And he gon' keep calling and trying, but you stand right, girl. And when you get on, and then you're asked for a white girl. Get down, girl, go hang it down. Get down, girl, go hang it down. Get down, girl, go hang it down.
Yeah, she take my money.
I say she's a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke.
I said the child.
I say she's a gold digger. Yeah, but she ain't messing with no broke. See, she's a gold digger. Get down, girl, go hang it down.
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 We love you guys.
Yes, thank you so much.
Let's
whoa.
All get hammered.
Man, I feel like the back of Crunchy's back. It's spent.
It's a little tight.
No, it's like, that's what I feel. That's like the sign. We're just like, no, I wouldn't, I mean, I'm in like, we're like in the refractory period now because we just...
We just
Crunchy's back was Austin.
Yeah.
And we're the...
We came we're, correct.
We're the dicks. Over.
Yeah, no, that's the thing.
Literally.
Yeah.
You want to sing along one last...
Yeah, you guys want to do a quick sing-along?
Quick sing-along.
All right, here we go. It's a song we wrote the other day.
Exactly. We're performing it's freestyle.
Oh, no. Attack is through. Is there something that I did? Is there something I can do? Oh no, night attack is done. My heart has been broken. The depression's just begun.
Brian Brushwood,
every time I leave, I wanna hurt myself by pissing off some bees. I'm allergic to bees. Oh, Justin Robert Young, every time you go, I get so sad that I wanna drink a warm glass of Drano.
All together!
Night attack! Night attack!
Night attack!
Night attack!
Night attack!
Night attack!
Night attack!
Night attack!
I love you!
But you're not your sriracha.
Thank you guys!
Like, it's like our third encore. We've been like,
what's that?
It's like our third encore. We've been
fine,
like saying goodbye.
I'm gonna get hammered and I'm gonna clean the sriracha out of my
yeah,
face.
No, do that first and then
Boss
get
Posse
hammered.
Is the best people ever. Thank you, guys.
One more time for the Boss and Posse.
Just one call for you. What you gonna do? And ain't no way to hide. Just one call for you. Let's all ring it in for Wally. AZC's Uncle Charlie, little Boo. I got to count him. And I'm gonna miss everybody on the road. All my gang, look to where they lay. Playing with destiny, play too deep for me to say. Little laser came on me, told me if you deep with deeply, bury me by my grand. When you can, come follow me. God bless you. We're gonna play through heaven. But the Lord, I'll 20-